Hi, everybody. My name is Zane Ferguson, and this is Scout Bourgeois, and she is here to answer some questions about the yearbook for us today. Scout, why are yearbooks $95 this year?
So I know that's something a lot of people are worried about, and although it's $95 this year, it's been $95 for as long as I can remember, as long as I've been working on the yearbook. And what's cool about it is that we added 40 more pages this year. So you get 40 more pages for the same price as last year, and that $95 helps us earn about $10 per book, which helps with our overall budget, that is $70,000.
Wow.
To make all of your guys' yearbooks.
Okay.
So it's not only a necessity, but it helps make the yearbooks better for next year as well.
So, Scout, where do you get a yearbook?
There are two places you can go. You can either go to the student finance office, or you can go online to yearbookforever.com and find Carson High School and order it that way.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. All right. Why should seniors buy yearbooks this year?
Personally, I think seniors should buy yearbooks because I know a lot don't or haven't bought yearbooks from freshman to junior year, and it's your last year in high school. It's your last year as a teenager. It's a lot of memories that you want to keep, especially like to look back in like 20 years, be like, hey, I forgot about senior sunrise, or I forgot about soccer, I forgot about whatever like activities they end up doing throughout the year. It's just a nice look back.
Yeah. Well, thank you for coming in and clarifying, Scout. We've had a lot of people coming in and asking a bunch of questions about that, so thank you so much for the insight.
Yeah, I'm happy to help.
Good morning, Senators. My name is Jalen Chapman.
And I'm Shauna Sigmund.
Welcome to Senators Now. If you got an acceptance application for Blue Crew, please make sure you get that turned into Miss Barber in the Hub as soon as you can. Congratulations on becoming a Blue Crew member for the 2023 to 2024 school year. Do you clean up your trash? Take a look at the effects of littering around our campus.
Hey there, Carson High. As you're watching this video, you will be seeing the trash that you and your peers leave lying around for custodians to pick up. The disrespect shown to the custodians is insane. Believe it or not, but cleaning up after yourself really isn't that hard. But if that wasn't enough to convince you, we'll showcase some side effects of leaving your trash out in the open. You're polluting the environment. If you're one of the few students who throws trash outside at lunch, shame on you. Not only are you making our school look less clean, but you're also affecting the environment too. You see, plastic wrappers in the tray served at lunch do not decompose naturally, and it could take up to 650 years just for it to decompose. When it does begin to decompose, it releases chemicals that are harmful for the environment. You might be asking, well, where does most of our trash go then? A majority of it goes into our school's waterways, but that's a problem. When it rains, that trash also gets taken along due to poor maintenance. And if that trash gets taken along with it, so are the chemicals that are being released. All that equals no clean water. However, in recent weeks, students from Hunsaker's class have been working on our waterways and taking trash out of them. What we're trying to convey here as a class is please throw your trash away where it belongs. Not outside, in the trash bag. Over the upcoming weeks, you'll be seeing posters around the school telling you to please throw your trash away. So take a look at the few posters around the school. Together, we can make this school a better place if we all pitch in and throw our trash where it belongs. So please, Senators, all we ask is that you please clean up after yourself and throw your trash away. Thank you.
All interested in playing sports for school year 2022 to 2023, the annual parent-athlete meeting will be on May 23rd in the Big Gym at 5:30 p.m. Sports Physical Night will be June 15th, also in the Big Gym at 5:30 p.m. Attention all students who will be enrolled in the Honors or AP Chemistry next year, 2022 to 2023 school year. Please visit Mr. McMillan in room 214 to pick up your summer assignment. These assignments will help you stay focused on what is important to know prior to the start of the new school year. There will be a meeting for any boys interested in playing soccer next season on Friday, May 20th at lunch in the Big Gym. Come meet the new boys soccer coach.
Seniors, have you been accepted to college or trade school, committed to a military branch? Share your celebration with the school and you'll be added to the Wall of Fame library window. Go to the Google Classroom and fill out the form. The National Honor Society is currently rolling out applications for 2022-2023 National Honor Society. To apply, please fill out the form in your grade level Google Classrooms. Applications are due May 20th. You will be notified by the end of the school year. Attention junior boys and girls. Boys and Girls State are taking applications for the summer. Please check out your Google Classroom for more information or see Ms. Lewis in the counseling office. Here's the wrap-up of the final days of the school year. The Zen Den.
Do you ever have a really rough day, or you have a day where you feel like nothing is ever going right? Everybody has those days, but we might have a room that could help you feel better. It's next to the counselor's office and the hub, and you just go into the library and you can see the hub. We call this place the Zen Den. In the Zen Den, as you can see, we have a piano where you can plug in the headphones and play. We also have hub laptops that you can use if your Chromebook's not working or if you just want to work in there. Those are our hub laptops. If you want to take them outside of the library, you will have to ask a library assistant. That's a TV for presentations if you want to use that, if you want to use it as a community space to do some group work. As you can see, we do have lots of different coloring tools, and below that, it's out of frame, but we do have lots of fidgets down there if you are feeling stressed. And we have really nice chairs that you can sit on and just relax if you're having a rough day. And yeah, that's the hub in the library, so if you ever want to come in there because you're feeling like you're having a rough day, just ask a library person.
That's it for today's announcements.
Thanks for watching.